Hi, and welcome back to our Open Stop Motion Film project. Yesterday we were putting clay on these where they were, where the wood and the plastic met. And today we are painting. As you can see, I have started and we are giving them more than one layer. And this time we are giving them two layers of this brown stuff, and then we are giving them a layer in another nuance, so that we, you know, nothing in the nature has just one color. So yeah, giving it some different ones. But the good thing with this acrylic paint is that it's dries very quick. But you can see there's a lot of them here we have to paint, and there is a lot of them over here also. And these one have not some are painted and some I haven't covered the cracks in this clay, so that we will do when we get so far. Or get to that point, or what we should call it. And as you saw, some of you saw yesterday, we I kind of smoothened the clay with I used oil to do that, and this acrylic paint is water based, so it don't stick as well. Sorry, and cover as good as we wanted to. But you can see this only an half hour since I painted this one, so, and now I can already give it a second time. So we get all of it. Covered. So we can't see it's printed in green plastic. Because that are not looking that good. But sooner or later it will, oops, I crawl out of the picture. Sooner or later it will be covered. And some of the trees are only in clay. As you see, where is here it is, As you see, the big one, the old oak, is clay. All of it is clay. And but the one right behind it is printed. So some of them, these trees I'm making here are kind of fill trees. And you can make many of the same kind, or more or less the same kind. You can see there are differences, but not much. When they look more or less similar, you don't recognize them. When you make a tree with a lot of character, you cannot make more of them, because you will, when you pan and you make the film, you will be able to see, oh, that tree is the same as that one, and so on. And then we spoil it all. The illusion get lost. One is nearly dry too. Maybe for you to see they are almost black, but they aren't. They are dark brown. But when we give it another makeover, then we will use another nuance, a lighter one. And there are hundreds of these trees. So we need a lot of them to make a forest. But I'm on this, on that stage in the making of things that I have to get some of the stuff finished. I have been like all over the place, made trees and then made heads to the characters, and then animals, and so that I could change between stuff to make it a little more interesting to look at. But now I need to finish up some of the stuff so I can start building the scenery on the, as you know, you cannot see all the table, but over here on the table the whole scenery will be built, the forest and the stream and the little lake and so on. So I'm on the point where if I don't do it, then I don't have any idea of how many trees I have to use and so on. I guess next month I will start to build the scenery. I have to be a little careful when I handle it so that I don't make too deep marks in the clay. But a good thing with this acrylic paint is that it gives a kind of harder outer shell of when I have put it on. And it's dry. And then, of course, I have to make a lot of leaves, two trees. And also, you who haven't seen it before, you can see there is leaves on one in the background, just to, so I could get an idea of how it would look and how I could make it look. You know, it's kind of trial and error all the time to figure out how to make it and how to make it in an easy way so that will be finished in a reasonable time. It takes a long time anyway, but there are only me here, so the quicker it goes, the better it is. so I can get it finished in my lifetime. That was a good idea. Or else you guys have to come and finish it for me. By the way, I saw the while I was restarting the system, I was out on the balcony and see and the swallows has arrived today. That was a good thing. So now it's summer in my book. So now the male are starting to build a nest and see if he can find a female and they can have some kids. And that's the fun part, is when they start to feed them. It's a barn swallow. Even I live in the city, then it is barn swallow anyway. We have around here. Pretty little bird, with blue and white. Love to take pictures of them. Nice to get this neon green plastic hidden, and the neon yellow clay. The clay I use is an oil-based clay, so people sometimes ask what clay I use. And it stays soft, and when you make figures with it, objects, then you can when you have scanned the figure in to the printer, then you can reuse it. Not in this case, but when you normal, when I make a mouse or a bird or something, it stays soft, it never dries. And then on one point, we have to start to make cast up some of the figures I have made, and make molds so I can make some silicone cast of it. And of course I haven't done that yet. I have to make some skeleton inside the mold so I can animate them. But I will get to that. Sooner or later. I'll hope I could start shooting sometime late next year, but I don't know. It's all depends. But there is a lot to do before that. This one was dry. Oops. One never knows what happened. But at least that's the goal. But as you can see, there is a lot of stuff to do. and all of it is really time consuming. There is no quick job in the stop motion. Oops. Put this one over here. This one kind of well, I have along the way found some easier way to do things. I don't know if any of you saw when I made crosses on all the figures I have modeled. To get a decent scan of them, I use 123D Catch, Autodesk product, to a cloud service to scan the figures I make. These trees, the top and bottom of these trees are made that way. First I model them and then I scan them and then I print them. But to print them I need a STL file, and I take pictures all around and kind of all around right on the figure and then all around on the kind of top, something about 20-40 pictures, and then 40 pictures and 360 degrees around figure, and then I send them to the cloud, and they are, of course, just 2D pictures. And then, out of those 2D pictures, 123D Catch makes a 3D picture. I then can edit and so on. I can edit in mass mixture or I can edit in the browser. But there was a long time where it was non-function. So I have had a little problem with that. Oh, that's kind of wet still. this too. Take a new one. And then sorry. And then I slice that 3D pictures in down to, I can slice them down to a tenth of a millimeter, and then the printer printed in layers. These are only, I think, 0.2 or 0.3. I don't remember. Every layer. I don't know if you can see a layer. You can. And this one. I think you can. But anyway. Then I print them out. But for a while this Autodesk service was down. I think it was because all the security with the browsers, where they upped the security in the browser, so you couldn't run script in it or programs in it, and this kind of depend on that, and it was broken a lot. Sometimes still is. And that kind of problem sets you back, because if I have to get a better scan, then I have to have a laser scanner, and not those cheap one you can buy. They are not worth anything if you did. Wanted to be a little accurate, and at least no one if of them are better than what you can do in that in Autodesk cloud scan. So but I used to make this good get it to make a good scan. I used to set crosses on. First, I followed the what shall I call the name? I followed what they said I should do in their videos, and just make some different marks around on the figure, but the scan did not end up good. So, and maybe that's because of this yellow clay. There's no texture in it, so it have big difficult to make a good scan of it. But I found out the best way I could do it was with making courses, but it took so long. But of course then I was speculating in how could I do it easier. And I took a toothbrush and some paint on it, and then I scratched over it, so it's just made stains on it, and kind of like if you were using an airbrush or something with a bad airbrush. So, and it works, and it's, they are really fine. Those are the best scans I've ever made. So, so you figure out things along the way. The toothbrush hair are very stiff, so there's splatter stains all over it. So, and it takes only 5 minutes, and the crosses could take the most of an evening to make. So. So it kind of you have to figure out new solution all the time. Oops. And remember to keep the stop in the screen in front of the camera, I mean. And then I had a lot of problems when I, the quality of the the streaming and the videos. I got some new cameras, and then I of course wanted it to be nice, but I couldn't really get it to work because, you know, I have the computer maxed out, one can say. It's a i7 but there's a lot of cards in it, and to stream this, as I had to have, for each camera I have to have a black magic card in it, in the computer, to code, transcode the stream. So sometimes it's not as easy as one thinks it would be. So there has been a lot of swearing around here. But we didn't stream that part. But I guess those who are watching this have a computer, and so you know how it can be. Yesterday it started, one of the external hard drives where I have this these videos on, kind of a backup. Windows was starting to tell me that I had to format hard disk before I used it, and that of course was a no-go, but I was afraid it was gone. But it was not the hard drive that was wrong. It was the connection in the laptop. You can see I have two screens, and I have screens in other places on the big computer, and then I have this little laptop so I can follow what's get out what's comes up on the screen, and it's that one I also use to load it up with so I don't max up the big one or max out the big one. Oops. And the little laptop there is only an i5 computer, Lenovo i5, Lenovo ThinkPad H. Are they called? One can say this operation here is kind of on the edge of what's possible all the time. And I think it is fantastic that we can do it. That every one of us can, if we wanted, can do things like starting a little podcast, netcast or whatever. Be fancy. And that, and you don't even need to put that much money in it, into it as I have done. You can just with a laptop and the camera built into the laptop, you can stream. And that I think is really cool. And especially when you are as old as me, seeing this I'm so old that I have built crystal radios when I was a kid, so and artificial stereo amplifiers before we had stereo. So this is a little wild. seen in that perspective. But that don't mean that we can't swear at it when it don't work. I did that too when I built Crystal Radio, and I have used a 100 watt soldering iron and burned up the diode. So I couldn't understand why it wouldn't work. But you get some nasty fingers with this. That's for sure. And when I'm finished painting these with this, they have to have a matte lacquer, so that you could take pictures, or else the light will come. This paint have a tendency to get really shiny. And you cannot manage the light if you didn't get rid of that shiny stuff. The trees in the woods don't shine. Maybe I just should have born a lot of bonsai trees. They comes with leaves. That would have been easier. And of course it has taken a lot of time to print each one of these. So when someone thinks, some are thinking that he's still working on those trees, and it takes a lot of time, it does. But for every stroke, I get a little forward. And then, of course, when I started, I also started with usually wet, normal clay. Same type of clay that you make pots of, and I had a lot of trouble with that. Because you cannot, if you don't finish the figure in one work process, then you cannot get on it the day after, then it cracks. The good thing about this is you can keep on it all the time. You can always change. But when you don't have any experience, that's the stuff you do. Could hope that I had time enough left in me to make another one when I'm finished with this one, so I can use the experience I have gotten. But I'm not so sure about that. I'm not so sure about that. But you have to admit that they look a little better in another color. I hate this neon stuff. But the reason have these colors is because when I order this stuff, then they, I don't think they sell so much of it. So sometimes they only have a lot of it in some colors, and I need a lot every time. So, and it don't matter what color it is. For the end result, but it is kind of bad to look at. And also some of the plastic you use to the printer had some problems on the way. I had some of the prints, the first head I printed out, they were in skin tone. I could get plastic like that, but the problem was with that was that the plastic was very bad. So I have, oops, now I made a dent in it. The plastic were a very bad quality, so. Oops, that was wet. And then after a while, the extruder in the printer burned out, so, and the printer was printing 24/7, so I'm a little hard on it, so it's burned out. And the problem is that I had to get a new one from the US, and that takes time too, so it's not always that you just can wait a little. It's not all that goes to plan. Sometimes it can be a hassle. Really can. Where is that? Is now some coffee is needed. Very much. So. And then I had all the kerfuffle with Google. They had decided that my site was a porn site. And I thought that was a little unfair. When I think my site is a family-friendly site, so. But they figured that out at last. That was, I think it was because at one time, I don't know if any of you could can remember, at one time there was a guy who made a site where you could hire a pixel or something for a dollar, or I don't know, and he made a million or something. And of course, other ones tried that too, and Pixel Fantasy was owned by such a guy, a German, before I bought it, but I didn't check it. I just found the name, and then it was available, and then I said thank you, and I take that one, pixelfantasy.com. But he have owned it back in 2006 or something like that. Anyway, long before I got it. So, and on his site there was a link to some adult toys or something. So, and I think Google's crawler had found that instead of mine, because they wouldn't have anything to do with me, and suggested that I change the name. Well, I will, and that was not in the cart. So all that kind of weird troubles are coming up along the way. And it's not so that you can get hold of Google or YouTube anywhere to cry out. But I understand why they do it. It's not that. I do understand them. Why me? That was the part I didn't understand. But that is fixed now, so nothing to complain about. And of course, then Justin, took the plug on me. One evening, they just put a sign up and said goodbye and thank you. And that was even a paid service I had. And I had a bunch of followers. But and I couldn't even say goodbye to them or anything. I of course had heard the rumors that, but I never expected them to just remove the block and then left me sitting on the stairs or the curb or whatever you call it. That was not nice. But I guess they are sitting on Bahamas and don't care. The whole thing. But I'm glad I have Google, or else this couldn't be done. Because they allow me to embed it on my site, so. And that's nice of them. And it don't cost me anything. And that's why I also have advertising on my videos, not that I ever will make any money. But I hope that YouTube makes money, because then they will not close it. And I know how expensive it is to stream stuff like this. So, if they don't make any money, they will close it. Oops. Start to do me up here first. they are actually, for those of you who have many viewers, and I don't, and I will never get it because this kind of niche. But those who make videos and so on, they do share the money with you, so that you get 55% of the revenue, and Google takes 45%, and that I think is pretty generous. And they have all the bills for the streaming. And when the year is gone, then I maybe get so I can buy a pack of clay. And that's fine with me. Of course, you will not be able to see this foot when it's mounted on the set. It will be hidden in the forest floor. But now I will close the terrace door because it's getting cold, and then I will hit the little boys' room. Oops. Second, whoops. I'm back. And my finger is clean again. That's a good thing. So we'll see if some of these are starting to get dry. So we can move it all around a little. we can give it a second layer. But it is so nice that the summer is here. The plan was that today I would have taken the trip to the forest, but that didn't occur. When you have a lot to do, then the time goes so incredibly fast. But tomorrow I will, because I'm getting my granddaughter from the kindergarten. So her and I will take a little trip. See if we can find a good picture or two to take with us home. And we will take some food and something to drink with us. And have a good time. She has the patience to be in a forest. big brother don't have it and have never had it, you as soon as we are 10 feet away from the car, he asked, can't we go back now? There has to happen something all the time with him. He a very busy guy. And now he only want to play Minecraft. That's his favorite occupation. And especially when he can get his uncle to play with him. That's the best thing in the world. In that game, they really hit the jackpot. I think old boys in that age, or girl maybe too, love to play Minecraft. tell this often, but people don't. Often understand. Why I do it this way, with not make short, small videos. And the reason is that then I have to edit them. And editing is also a time-consuming thing, and the time I'm editing, I'm taking from this. So and I do not expect anyone to sit through and 4 hours ordeal of me painting trees or modeling faces or whatever I do. I prefer to see it like kind of an open house, that open studio, so you can come by and see how far I've gotten, and then go on to the next. The next thing on your way. I will, of course, always do my best to make it as entertaining as possible, but there's limit to how nerve-wracking it can be. I need one more computer so that I can run Skype at the same time, so then I maybe can invite some guests and we can have a conversation. So that will be better than my monologue. At least that's the plan. There is a limit to how many, how much money I can use on this. And I use a lot. And had used a lot, so. Need to use a lot more, but I'm not a rich man, so. Just buy and buy and buy and buy stuff. Even that I like to my compressor through the airbrush exploded, so I need a new one of those. That's $1,000. And so on. So it has to be a little at a time. So I wait to buy till I get to the point where I need it. I got a $2,000 extra electric bill with all my spots and stuff. So here in my country we pay every 3 months. We pay, or every quarter we pay for the electric bill, and then when the year is over, they check how much I have been using, and then if I have used more than I have paid, then I get an extra bill. So, and I add, because I'm using light all the time. And a lot of it the net, and or other stuff that is expensive. You don't pay your electric bill, then they cut the little man with the pliers come around and cut the. So, and we can't see anything. And that isn't good. And one more in the row. Right. one tree at a time. Hundreds more to go. Dream. Looking forward to a day where this flash stuff is gone. And the church bell are ringing. Sorry. So. One more. Need to get some coffee down that throat. has to remember to get it the whole way around. All around the stick. We don't leave spots. We can't have that. This afternoon I made cuts on the videos, but I didn't get finished with it. Something like 70 videos on YouTube, and if you use cards then you have to do it on every single one of them, one at a time. So because you can do it different, or you can do it all of them the same, and you can there is 5 types of cards you can to put on there. I use the kind that you are referring to your own site. And the reason I do that is, as I said before, since Justin got bought and closed, I've gotten a little paranoid. So that you never know with these systems. Because I really don't care where the stuff are seen, but if it's on YouTube or on my title on the D Plus or Facebook, think it is important to have one's own home on the net. Even though all the I have a archive on archive of all the videos on I have on my side, so but they are of course embedded, so if YouTube close tomorrow they will all disappear. But I have the videos, but here, but then I have to find another place, and that can be a little tricky. But let us hope that YouTube will last my time out. Or yours too. For those of you who have something up there. Many have a YouTube channel, so and I think it's a good thing to have one, even you maybe not have anything particular to use for it right now, but later on. Have a name or domain, then it's best to grab it right away. You never know. I think every young person in the future will have a video channel of some kind. My grandson and daughter (clears throat) will be or brand, I mean, or YouTube or something else. I think over time it will be cheaper and cheaper to stream, so you will be able to stream your own stuff and don't have to buy the service at the your internet provider. But I know some of some countries have a long way to go yet before that even will be possible. They just want to have a good connection as is now. I know a lot of my American friends are suffering from bad internet. And that's a shame. But I guess sooner or later the government, the American government, have to do something so that they can get internet out to the rural district and some of the smaller towns that have bad connections. But I think Google have done are doing a good work with offering different town fiber. Kind of pushes the other companies a little, I hope. Yes, in Scandinavia most of us have good net, or at least can buy it if we want it. I have 60 up and 60 down. I think last month they offered me 300 down, but I would rather have 300 up or half of it up. But I didn't check if I could make it like that. Now I can decide myself how I will have it. With the 60-60 I can adjust it myself so I have more up or more down
whatever I want.
So we are a little spoiled in that direction, but I hope everyone else will be that soon too. I think it's very important that every person in the world have a good internet connection. Not to see my stuff, but but to learn whatever they want to learn, and you can pretty much get nearly everything on the net today. Universities have learning programs, and many of them have it for free. You can take courses in whatever if you like to. And with good educations, then I think a lot of the troubles we have around the world today will get much better. Who got that idea we need to make a forest? Make a forest. Like to know that. Unbelievable. second again. But they kind of look better on the screen with the colors on. Because it's a little dark. It's a little dark. That's a lot of sticks on this one. I see if I can get some of them sprayed with lacquer tomorrow. Because I want to do it outdoors on the balcony. So that. There is a lot of fumes when you do this. So it's best to do outdoors, and then now it's dark outside, so I can't see. And they need to be really dry to be sure that it ends well. But we will see how much I get done tomorrow. Because when you have a 6 year old little girl running around, then there is a limit to what you can do. How efficient you can be. To be a little realistic in that way. Sticks to the Need to clean the brush a little. Stiff. When the paint dries in the upper part of the hair, and I don't know yet if I want to print the skeleton in the figures, or I want to make them out of metal. You can buy those skeletons too. They are pretty expensive, and there is a lot of actors in this movie. I haven't made it easy for myself. That was a shame to say. The main character is Flint, or his name is Flint, and he have a friend, and he have a little sister, and he have a father and a mother, a whole family, and his friend have a whole family of many persons. So, and there are tons of them. And a lot of, what should we say, movement in the scene. Some of the scenes of a lot of figures. So it would cost a fortune if I did buy figures like that, or a skeleton like that. I think I have to make another solution. Sorry, but I'm multitasking, and I'm a really bad one doing that. So I will stop it. So I will anyway make them myself, so I have to figure out how. Will do that. There will be a lot of wear and tear on them, so metal would be the best solution. But this plastic here is very hard, so maybe this will be good enough if I printed it. I will have to make some test. It's the same material as Lego bricks are made of, and most of you know how hard that is. So. It will sustain a lot, but how much, that's the question. And the software I have bought to make the movie with is Dragon Frame. It's a really good, and if you want to try to make a little stop motion with your kids, and you can use the Lego figures, then you can download it for free, and it is full function, but you can only save I think it's a minute, but you can make a nice little stop movie on a minute. So, and that's the only restriction there is. It is full function. And it's very easy to use. And a fun experience. I tried it when I was looking for what to use before I bought it. I tried it myself with a little Lego figure. And I think that's up there somewhere on the YouTube on my side. I think it's called I Have a Cold, and that's made in Dragon Frame in the trial version. And the kids will love it, I guarantee. They find it very fun. and can even participate. And they have a good imagination, so. It's always fun to have them on board. And it's a good understanding for them to learn how a movie works. This one picture at a time and one movement at a time. And the good thing with a modern stop motion tool like Dragon Frame and others, that is, they are ghosting, so you have a picture of where the, when you are moving the figure, you can see where it was just the shot before. You can see two shots at a time, so it's easier. To much easier to make a fluid movement and remember where it was a minute ago and move it accordingly to that. And it is fun for the kids to certainly see their toys turning live. And it's a good thing if you have something that can shoot macro. If you have a newer golden, if you have a DSLR to then you can connect that to the laptop and then have the Dragon Frame on the laptop, and you can you can control the camera from the program. I will recommend you to try whatever you have. It is fun. And especially if you have some kids around you. And you will even be able to compete with Minecraft. When they see what you are doing. I think if they are 10 years old or 9, 10 years upwards, then they will be able to do it themselves and have a really fun time doing it. I think they have to be their own. Of course, that kids are different, but some kids will. Before you know it, you have a little filmmaker on your hand. Making Star Wars movie or whatnot. That I think will be worth the effort. I remember when I was a kid, we had, or my big brother had, don't know what the name of it was, but it was a kind of toy projector. So we sat in the closet and there was a light in it, so we played cinema, and that was before television and everything else. Good memory. I'm sometimes I'm a little afraid for the younger generation of kids, that they are not learning to do stuff themselves. I know it's I sound like an old man, but I am, but I think it's a good thing to be able to make and understand to make stuff, whatever it is. It's kind of everything most kids do nowadays, it's depending on electricity, and if there's no electricity or batteries, then they are often lost. I always admire when I see kids from Africa where they are pretty poor, or some of the kids are, and they out of very simple Coca-Cola cans or stuff like that, have built cars, really amazing toys. And that's a skill they can use in many other circumstances later in life. And I know as soon as they get an iPad or tablet or something, they will use that too, and they will learn it as fast as everybody else. But then they still have the other things in their backpack, so that they can use in many other situations in life. Always good to know how things work. The first time I saw television, that was in 1953, I saw it first time. One family in the block got a TV. And all the children in the yard got invited up to see this fantastic TV stuff. Their whole living room was full of children. But I spent my whole time wondering how they got that stuff into the box. And when they was living on the top floor, and when I get back in the yard, I had seen in the before noon, they have been up drilling through the roof, some men, and put a big tube down the roof, and some, as I know today, antenna up there. But so somehow I knew that it had to get down to that, so, and that was a little puzzle for me. So I thought it, when we were up seeing the telly, there must be something coming through the air, like a roll or something that fits with the tubing. But I knew I didn't really understand it, so I swore with myself, one day I will figure out how that worked, and I did. Because I became later what is it called? I became a technician, the electronic kind. So, and I have been working on Bang & Olufsen in Denmark, and as a technician. And I have been making fighter jet in Sweden, so today I know how it works. But I'm a little afraid that kids nowadays don't wonder how it works, but just take it for granted. Because they don't. Of course, some of them will learn it and will. I want all of them to have a little mechanic and electronic knowledge. but contrary to many of my equal in age, I'm not I know it sounded like that, but I'm not as afraid as afraid for the future as many old people are, because that the kids don't, that they get spoiled and it's dangerous with all the computer stuff. It is not. They learn a lot with a lot of the games. The Minecraft, they learned a lot with when they are playing with Minecraft. Generation have always been afraid of new times, but new times have always proven them wrong. So that's not my goal. I just want them to know most possible. Have a little better understanding of what's going on and how it works. And then they will manage fine. It's fun to make something with your own hands, your own garden shed or whatever, repair your own car. It's being increasingly harder because of all the electronics in them. But your own lawnmower or something like that. There is a little pride and satisfaction involved in that, and that's what I'd like them to have. I will run for a second. There is not much room in here. Someone have filled it all up with stuff. And it's not me, I think. It is not me. Time goes fast. We have already used 3 hours. My God. Maybe I'm talking too much, making too little. That could be the course. See how many I get. I managed to get finish. I had hoped I could finish all of them tonight. It goes. Maybe when I'm finished with this, I have got enough wood and trees for a lifetime. Who knows? I don't hope so, because the forest is my favorite place. It's really good, then maybe I love it in even more. Let us hope that. Don't. They break when they fall, because extruder was bad when I printed these. I think I soon will order a couple of more extruders so that I have in case of they change the model or whatever. Do I know what this one get? The new one get tired. On one point. Of course they do burn out over time, but if I have a extruder then I can always fix it. And then a couple of step motors would be nice to have too. The printer I have I ordered as a kit, so I could build it myself and better get an understanding of how it worked. And the it is pretty simple. You can see it as a glue gun on rails. Of course, the electronics are a little more sophisticated, but it's not that technical device. And I know some of the smaller models, they had smaller step motors in them, and a lot of those burned. But I don't think they use those anymore. It's a PrinterBot I have. A PrinterBot Plus. And the reason I chose that was because of it was the printer that could take the biggest object, print the biggest object, and I kind of needed that. And I have been very happy with it. But it's not like you can put a file in it and then just push the button and then let it all on its own devices. And that is nothing to do with what kind of printer you have. They are all like that. I know some of them try to let you believe that theirs are easier than the others, but they aren't. They all have the same issues, the same strengths, and it's kind of early days for 3D printing. It's not a household appliance, so that you just tell it to print a tree and off it goes, and printing a tree. There's a lot of errors and failed prints. Even now that, and I print a lot of print. I still sometimes have troubles understanding what's wrong and why do we do like it does. And I have bought cheap plastic and I have bought expensive plastic and tried everything. Oops, don't. Maybe it goes a little too fast now. Takes the time it takes. But don't push it. So, we have no more on that side. Boops. So they are all moved over here. To give the last one once a second time. But we still need a third time on all of them. So I'm afraid we are not gonna do it all tonight. Half an hour for midnight or something like that, yes. In one way, I'm a very patient person, but another way, I'm a very unpatient person. I want to get it all finished tonight. Film and everything. So, I don't know. I'm a little AD, I think. In some ways, not all. Take those behind first. I sometimes forget I'm looking forward to the time where they can teleport. Then each of you could make one and send it to me via teleporting. Then we could make it all in an evening. I think but that's not the case, so when I heard Elon Musk, the Tesla guy, had an announcement, so I was hoping for teleportation. So maybe he will bail me out. We can be his first guinea pigs in the beta version, sending trees around. That could be fun. Oops. I would love that. I'm sure we will get there. One time. I remember sitting and tuning on the radio shortwave and hearing music and speech from countries far, far away. That was crazy, amazing. And now I can sit in a little studio in a little town in Denmark and everyone in the world with a computer can follow along. So that's nearly as wild as teleportation. I would love to see how the world looked 50 years from now. I'm sure it will be mind-boggling. I think I will take a laptop and install Skype on it in the grave, so my grandchildren can Skype me and tell how it went. Wouldn't that be nice? I think we need to put some over here again, because I cannot have them all here. These are finished with the second time. And this one. race to the finish. But I will not be able to do it. And the reason I am so obsessed with 4 hours is that YouTube will not save anything more than 4 hours. Finish. Oh, it burned out for today. Started 8 o'clock this morning and now it's midnight, and so at some point it's a little difficult to keep on. Sorry. So we got one more finished. So I only need to make these last four before I. But I will say thanks to you all, and thank for viewing and passing by, and hopefully I'll see you again tomorrow. Good night.